Welcome everyone to another great Nintendo special coming live to you from the Nintendo stage here at Gamescom in Cologne, Germany. It's so good to have you guys with us today. Are you guys in a good mood? I'm not quite sure. Do we have some Super Mario Odyssey fans here? Come on, let's do this again. Do we have some Super Mario Odyssey fans here? That's what I wanted to hear, exactly. And I guess you guys tuning in from home are also Odyssey fans, and that's a good thing because this show is all about Super Mario Odyssey. So I have to ask, are you guys excited for Super Mario Odyssey? Yeah, so am I, so am I. I guess it's fitting that we have a very special guest today. He's joining us soon on stage because he's going to talk about Super Mario Odyssey. But let's give us some background information. Since joining Nintendo in 1991, he has worked on titles like Super Mario 64, The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, Super Mario Galaxy, and many, many more. And today he's here to talk about Mario's newest adventure. It's, of course, Super Mario Odyssey, which is coming out to Nintendo Switch on 27th of October. So guys, are you ready? Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Koizumi!
Guten Tag, Deutschland!
Hello, Mr. Koizumi!
Nice to see you.
Please take a seat. It's so good to have you here. And we are also joined by Alex, our translator. Hey, Alex, it's good to have you here. Hi. And of course, also Filippo, who's going to help us out with the gameplay. So, Mr. Koizumi, welcome to Gamescom.
Hi, thank you. I'm very happy to be here.
Thank you for the warm welcome. I always enjoy my time here in Europe.
We are so happy to have you here in Europe and especially here in Cologne at the Gamescom. So it's actually your first trip to the Gamescom, right?
Hi, actually, Kirin and Kuro are also like this, but actually, it's the first time to come to
Germany. Yes, it is. It's my first time in Cologne and actually my first time ever in Germany.
Oh, I see.
Actually, the first time to come to Germany is... Thank you. ドキドキワクワクして楽しいですね.
It's always so exciting to visit any country for the first time. It's just a lot of fun.
Yeah, I see that.
そして会場の皆さんがお会いすることができてとても嬉しいです。
And it's really great to see so many of you guys here in the venue with us today.
It really is. So Mr. Koizumi, you're obviously here to talk about Mario's newest adventure, Super Mario Odyssey. And I guess many of our audience members already know what it's all about. But for all the people who are not exactly sure what Super Mario Odyssey is all about, maybe you can tell them a little bit more.
はい、それでは今からお話をさせてもらおうと思います。今回のマリオは旅をテーマにしたゲームにしようと私たちのチーム考えて作ってきました。
Sure, I'd love to tell you guys about the game. We on the development team thought it would be really cool to make a Mario game with the theme of travel.
まあ世界中を旅して初めて訪れる旅先でこれまで見たこともないものに出会ったり体験したりをマリオを通じて楽しんでいただければなと思っています。
We want people playing the game to get that sense of traveling to new places around the world and discovering things that they've never seen or experienced before.
それのためにこれまで似合わないマリオのアクションを用意してきました。
And to help with that, we've also included some brand new moves for Mario.
今回の冒険ではキャッピーという新しいマリオのパートナーが加わるんですけど、彼はちょうどこんな。なんかあっちにもいっぱいいますね。こんな感じの帽子の形でした。
So on this adventure, Mario is joined by a new partner called Cappy, who looks a lot like this.
キャッピーは敵に乗り移るキャプチャーという能力をはじめ、遠くにいる敵を攻撃したり、アイテムを手に入れたり、投げることでマリオにいろいろな技を授けてくれるんです。
And Cappy gives Mario some new moves.So by throwing Cappy, Mario can capture an enemy, which means taking them over and using their skills. But that's not all. Cappy can also attack enemies from a distance, and he can collect items for Mario.
皆さんにはキャッピーで何にキャプチャーできるかをいろいろ試して楽しんでもらえたらなと思います。
So we hope players will enjoy experimenting with Cappy to see who and what he can capture.
That brings me to a question, because I see that you have your very own Cappy there. So is there any kind of specific Mario enemy that you would like to capture?
そうですね。T-Rex ですかね。
That's a very good question. I think it would have to be the T-Rex.
Yeah.今回のマリオのもう一つのテーマ、驚きというテーマがあって、恐竜になってケルの街を走り回ってみんなを驚かしてみたいです。
Because you know, another theme of our new Mario game is surprise, and I'd love to see the surprise look on everyone's face if I could transform into a dinosaur and rampage around the streets of Cologne.
I can imagine, like, whoa, Mr. Koizumi going around. Nice, that's good. So thank you very much for giving us a nice explanation of what Super Mario Odyssey is all about. But I guess many of our audience members are questioning, is there anything new that you could show us today?
わかりました。では、ほんのちょっとだけ。
Well, as it happens, yes, I do have a little something.
Yes.
ですね、料理の王国という新しい王国をご紹介します。
I'd like to show you a new kingdom called the Luncheon Kingdom.
Oh, I would love that.
見たままなんですけども、この王国のテーマ、私も、旅先ですごい楽しみにしている。それは食べ物です。
So as you can see, the theme of this kingdom is something that I personally always really look forward to when I'm traveling around. That's food.
Oh, me too.
まあ、今回ドイツに初めて来て、これまで食べたことないものいろいろ挑戦してみましたよ。
And this week in Germany, I've been enjoying trying lots of different foods that I'd never eaten before.
特にお気に入りなのはシュニッツェル。
And I especially liked Schnitzel.
Great choice, great choice. I guess there are many audience members here who are Schnitzel fans as well, right? Sounds like we have some Schnitzel fans. Nice. So...Mr. Koizumi, obviously you came here by plane, but how does Mario travel?
はい、そうですね。マリオも同じようにオデッセイ号で、王国から王国へ空を飛んで移動することができます。
Well, actually, yeah, it's kind of similar. Mario flies between the kingdoms in his ship called the Odyssey.
出てますかね。この地球儀で行きたい場所を選んで、飛んでいきます。
So yeah, you choose a location on the globe and you can travel there directly.
そういう意味では、ここはマリオ64のビーチ城やスーパーマリオサンシャインのドロピックタウンのような中継地点がない世界なんですね。
So in this game, there's actually no central hub world, like for example, Peach's Castle in Super Mario 64 or Delfino Plaza in Super Mario Sunshine.
マリオはオデッセイ号で、とある地球を股にかけてクッパを、追いかけるんですけど、追いかけていきます。
And Mario is chasing Bowser around the globe in the Odyssey.
そのためには、行く先々の王国でオデッセイ号を動かすのに必要なパワームーンをたくさん集める必要があります。
But in order to do this, he needs to collect power moons. And these are found in each kingdom he visits, and he uses them to power the Odyssey.
王国にはたくさんパワームーンが隠されていますので、くまなく探してみてください。
And actually, there are lots of power moons hidden in each kingdom. So if you want to find them all, you'll have to explore really thoroughly.
はい、それでは実際に料理の王国に行ってみましょう。
Now, why don't we actually travel to the Luncheon Kingdom and take a look?
Oh yeah, that would be great, right? Let's do this. So...Filippo, as you already have the Joy-Cons, please dive into the gameplay and show us something of the Luncheon Kingdom. The first seconds, I just love this game. I'm so excited for it. It's really beautiful. And I love the fact that you have this nice, nice, nicely designed world. There's so much to explore, as we can see right now. Nice. Okay, Peronza Plaza it is.So, as we can already hear the music right now, so what was this kingdom's inspiration?
音楽、聞こえませんかね。分かると思うんですけども、イタリアという方はヨーロッパを、イメージしています。
Well, you can probably tell from this music, But the kingdom was partly inspired by Italy and other European countries.
あのヨーロッパには素晴らしい食の文化がありますので、料理をイメージした王国を作るにはやっぱりヨーロッパがのテイストが一番合うと思いました。
Europe has a really rich variety of food cultures and cuisines. So when we were thinking of making a food-themed kingdom, it seemed like a natural choice to give it a European flavor.
あのこの国はマリオデッセイの中でも特徴的なアートになってます。
I also think this kingdom has quite a unique art style within the game.
あのニュードンクシティのような私たちの世界に近いような国もあれば、この国のようなデフォルメされたアートの国もあるんです。
So some kingdoms in Super Mario Odyssey look quite similar to our own world. An example of this would be New Donk City. But some of them, like this one, have a more surreal or cartoon-like vibe to them.
Yeah, definitely. And as we can see these forks right now, why do they look so unhappy?
あの火山の上にですね、大きな鍋があるんですけれども、それをまあさらに大きな、まあ、鳥が取ってるんです。
Well, there's a big cooking pot at the top of the volcano, as you can see.This pot belongs to those fork guys, but also, as you can see, this big bird has come down and he's kind of taken over the pot.
鍋の中身気になりますよね。
I bet you're wondering what's inside the pot.
Absolutely, I'm a foodie.
あ、この中身はですね、祝福のシチューと呼ばれているこの国の名物料理です。
So it's this kingdom's most famous dish called Stupendous Stew.
これをクッパが狙ってるんです。
But,Bowser's also got his eye on the stew.
This damn Bowser. So can you tell us a little bit more about the crazy cap shot as we are seeing him right now?
はい、あのクレイジーキャップがニューヨークシティに本店がある帽子屋さんです。
So Crazy Cap is a hat store which has its headquarters in New York City.
あのコインや、それぞれの国にある紫色のローカルコインを使って買い物することができます。
So you can buy things there using the regular coins that you will collect throughout the game, but you can also buy things using the purple regional coins that are found in each kingdom.
お店にあの帽子以外にも服が売ってたり、お土産物が売ってたり、冒険に役に立つアイテムを売ってたりします。
And in addition to hats, you can also buy clothes, souvenirs, and a variety of other items that will help Mario on his journey.
そのお店でしか売ってないものもありますので、お店見かけたらぜひ立ち寄ってみてください。
There are also some items that can only be bought in one particular branch of the store. So if you see a crazy cap store, you should always make sure to visit it.
あ、マリオがシェフの格好をしましたね。じゃあシェフらしく美味しい料理作ってみてくださいね。
So Mario's changed into chef's clothing now. Let's see if he can get stuck in and help with some cooking.
This stew looks so delicious.
Oh.
Well done. So, now that we see this pink stuff, what is it actually? It looks so delicious. Can we jump into it?
あの、美味しそうに見えるんですけど、とても熱い溶岩なんで気をつけてください。
Well, it might look delicious, but actually it's lava. Oh. And it's very, very hot, so you have to be careful around it.
Question is, how do we get across?
そうですね。そこにあるいろいろそのオレンジ色のバブルにぴょんぴょん跳ね跳ねるバブルにキャッピーを投げてみてください。
So you can see this orange lava bubble here. Try throwing Cappy at it.
Oh, キャプチャーできましたね。これであの熱い溶岩の中をスイスイと移動できるようになりました。
So Mario's now captured the lava bubble, and he can swim freely through the lava.
およかった、はい、ちょっとジョイコンを振ってみてください。早く移動できます。
Try shaking the Joy-Con. It lets you move more quickly.
あの実はこれだけ自由に溶岩の上を動けるのはマリオシリーズでも初めてなんですよ。
And this is actually the first time ever in a Mario game that you've been able to travel so freely through hot lava.
あ、ハンマーブロスですね。
We've got some Hammer Brothers here.
このハンマーブロスのハンマーじゃなくてフライパン投げてますね。
These Hammer Brothers aren't actually throwing hammers. They're throwing frying pans.
あのさっきのタイトルでチーズ岩の下にってありましたが、この黄色いのがチーズ岩です。
And you might have noticed earlier that the title of this gameplay section was Under the Cheese Rocks. Well, here we have the yellow cheese rocks.
硬いのでこれはどんどんとフライパン投げて壊していく。
But you can't actually eat this cheese. You have to use the frying pans to break it apart.
Go, 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 go. Oh. Go, 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 go. Oh, go, 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 go.
Oh, just a little bit more.
Ah, 出た。出れました。はい。はい、パワームーン取れるようになりましたね。
So we've found a power moon, and now Filippo can go and grab it.
こんな感じで他にもこの王国には他にパワームーンがありますので、いろいろ探してみてください。
But just like this, there are lots of power moons dotted around the kingdom, so you really need to try hard to find them all.
例えば火山の上に、大きな鳥が居座ってましたよね。見えますか？
And for example, you might remember that big bird we saw at the top of the volcano. That's a place you might want to check out.
Come on, I can't wait. So Mr. Koizumi, thank you so much for bringing us more details of this highly anticipated game. It's so great to have you here, and I can't wait for the final game.
はい、こちらこそ、皆さんにお会いできてとても楽しかったです。
Thank you for having me. I've really enjoyed being here. I've really enjoyed meeting all of you.
それから料理の国を紹介することもできてよかったです。
And I was really happy to introduce the Luncheon Kingdom to you.
このプレゼンの後に、このプレゼンの後にもう少しこの王国についての詳しいプレゼンがさらにありますので、そちらの方もお楽しみください。
But stay tuned, because shortly after this, there'll be another live-streamed presentation that's going to go into a bit more detail about the Luncheon Kingdom.
それでは10月の27日の発売まであともうちょっとあるんで、それまでお待ちください。
And the game is released on October the 27th, so just a little while longer to wait.
Just a little bit, exactly. So, Mr. Koizumi, since it's so great to have you here, would you do us the honor and come to the front of the stage so we can get a big round of applause for Mr. Koizumi? And maybe he can also say goodbye.
Danke schön. Tschüss.
Thank you very much, Mr. Koizumi.Thank you very much, Alex. Thank you very much, Filippo. Thank you guys attending our live show here, and thank you very much for tuning in. See you. Here we go, off the rails. Did you know it's time to raise our sails? It's freedom like you never knew.
Thank you.
Thanks, David. You could say my hat is off to you. Oh, we can zoom all the way to the moon of this great wide wacky world. Jump with me, grab coins with me, oh yeah.